Hello everyone. I hope that you have completed exercise of chapter number 4, that is sorting materials into groups. So let's start to discuss question answers. Question number 1, name 5 objects which can be made from wood. So here you have to write objects that made up of wood only. Okay, you can write anything. I have written 5 examples. See, table, chair, toys, bed and door. It is not necessary to write these answers only, you can change these answers. Okay, understood question number 1? Yes. Now question number 2, select those objects from the following which shine. We have learned the properties of objects. Okay, the shiny lustrous objects are there. So 4 objects already given here, you have to just find out that which ones are shiny. Glass bowl, plastic toy, steel spoon and cotton shirt. See the answer. Things which are shine are glass bowl and steel spoon. I hope that you have written that answer only. Understood the second question? Yes, things which shine are glass bowl and steel spoon. Okay, now question number 3, match the objects given below with the materials from which they could be made. Remember, an object could be made from more than one material and a given material could be used for making many objects. Means it is not compulsory that you can use only one material to make only one object. Okay, for example, like toy. Toys are made up of wood also, toys are made up of glass also, toys are made up of plastic also. But choice or match the following properly. See the answer I have written here. Book, normally book is made up of paper. So I have written here paper. Okay. First, see these objects and then match with that materials. Okay. Don't confuse. So object book is made up of paper, then tumbler is made up of glass, chair is made up of wood, I have written here, toy is made up of plastics and shoes is made up of leather. Check book, paper, tumbler, glass, chair, wood, toy, plastics and shoes, leather. Understood question number 3? Yes. Now come on question number 4. State whether the statements given below are true or false. As usual, you have to write the false if the sentence is what? Correct or not? If the sentence is not correct, you have to write false. If the sentence is correct, you have to write true. See the first one. Stone is transparent while glass is opaque. So the answer is false. Stone is opaque and glass is transparent. Correct? Yes. So the first statement is false. Next, a notebook has luster while eraser does not. Tell me. Means what you have written? Yes. The answer is false. Neither notebook nor eraser having luster. Okay. Both are non-lustrous objects. Then third one, chalk dissolves in water. The statement is false. Okay, chalk cannot mix in water properly, so that's why I have written false. Question number 4, a piece of wood floats on a water. Yes, we have learned that which things are floating, which things are sink in water. So a piece of wood floats on water and the statement is true. Next one, sugar does not dissolve in water. We have learned the property solubility and insolubility. So sugar is dissolving in water and that's why the statement is false. Next, oil mixes with water. We have learned that immiscible liquids. Oil does not mix with water and that's why the statement is falls. Next one, sand settles down in water. Yes, that statement is true. And the last one, vinegar dissolves in water. This statement is also true. Vinegar in liquid form, water is also in liquid. So both are mixed with each other, and that's why the statement is true. Understood the true or false? Yes. Now come on question number 5. Given below are the names of some objects and materials. See, objects are also given and the materials are also given. See, water, basketball, orange, sugar, globe, apple, and earthen pitcher. Group them as round shape and other shapes, eatables and non-eatables. Means here you have to do classification, which things are round shape and which things are in other shapes, that you have to write. So first we will do about round shaped and other shapes. So which things are in round shape? See, I have written here that are basketball, then orange, then globe, apple, and earthen pitcher. So all these things are round shaped. And what are the things that are in other shapes? See, water and sugar. These things are not in round shape, and that's why I have written here. Understood? Yes. Now come on the second group, that is eatables and non-eatables. Eatables means what? We can eat that things. And non-eatables means we cannot eat that things. So see which things are in eatables: water, orange, sugar, and apple. Very good. See, the things that are in non-eatables are basketball, globe, and earthen pitcher. Completed? Yes. So here we have learned about classification. Now because of properties that we know, that's why we have done this classification correct. Now question number 6. List all the atoms known to you that float on water. Check and see if they will float on an oil or kerosene. Means you have to write some things that float on water and that float on an oil or kerosene. Kerosene means your rockel. So see, I have written here many things that float on water, like a piece of paper, then wood, balloon, plastic bottle, ice, and boat. So these things that float on water, and then see list of atoms that float on an oil or kerosene, that are piece of paper, plastic bottle, balloon, and wood. Okay, so all these things I have written here, you can write in your own words. Okay, next question number 7, the last question of your exercise. Here you have to find out the odd one out from the following. Okay, see, first group: chair, bed, table, baby, and cupboard. Tell me the answer. Yes, the answer is baby. Why? Because chair, bed, table, and cupboard all are non-living things, and baby is a living thing. So the answer is baby. Then see the next group: rose, jasmine, boat, marigold, and lotus. So the answer is boat. Very good, because rose, jasmine, marigold, lotus are flowers. Okay, boat is not a flower, and that's why the answer is boat. Next one: aluminium, iron, copper, silver, and sand. The answer is sand, because remaining all are metals, like aluminium, iron, copper, and silver. The remaining are metals, and that's why the answer is sand. See the next group and the last group, that are sugar, salt, sand and copper sulfate. Now here you have to find out the property of solubility. So the answer is sand, because sugar, salt and copper sulfate all are soluble in water, but the sand cannot soluble, means cannot mix with water, and that's why the answer is sand. Okay, so here we have completed our exercise. Check your answer that you have written in your notebook. Okay, thank you.